Hello from National Library of Lithuania. It's a pity that we couldn't meet in Tartu, but this opportunity is also very fine and it's so good to meet at least you online. The goal of my presentation is to show you how libraries, what kind of benefits gave libraries to its users. We started counting in 10 years ago, and then we measured again in 2019. At first, I would like to introduce myself. I am Giedrė Čistovienė. I work at the National Library for more than 10 years. And at the moment, I'm the head of project management unit. And I started working with various projects more than 10 years ago, and especially I feel experienced in projects related with public internet access points. A few words about the network of Lithuanian public libraries for those who do not know. At the top of the network is National Library of Lithuania, not because all libraries belong to National Library, it's just because we are the methodic center. We and five county libraries belong to Ministry of Culture and 60 municipal with more than 1,200 branch libraries belong to municipalities. So we have different owners, but we work as one network for more than 30 years, I believe. More than 1,000 libraries are in rural areas. Also, we have strong associations like County Libraries Association, Municipal Libraries Association, also Librarians Association, and quite a lot for such a small country. But when we advocate libraries, we advocate not as three voices, but we advocate as one voice. So this is our, for this we are, other culture institutions think that we are a very strong power. At first, we were only beneficiaries concerning public internet access points, but I will tell the story how we became leaders in this field. Projects related with public internet access points started in 1997, and we got funding from Open Society Foundation, from FAIR projects, from EU structure funds, and the owner of these projects was Ministry of Interior. Libraries were only beneficiaries, and also not all public internet access points were in libraries. We had some in other institutions, but only those who were created in libraries survived, because it wasn't easy to sustain these points at other institutions when the project was ended. Later in 2008, we got funding from Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation, and finally we took it into our hands together with Ministry of Culture, not Ministry of Interior. This time we were working together with Ministry of Culture. And the budget of this project was more than 50 million euros. It lasted for more than 4 years. In 2008, we started a project which we implemented by ourselves together with Ministry of Culture. The budget of the project was more than 50 million euros, and we involved more than 1,200 libraries, almost all libraries. And then in 2014, we had another project funded by Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation. And the main coordinator was National Library of Lithuania. We did it by ourselves, and just Ministry of Culture gave us some own contribution to the funding. And this project was based on the results of previous projects, because we had great infrastructure And now we wanted some more soft activities. I will tell about this later. And now we are implementing another project. It is funded by EU structure funds. We are also doing it by ourselves together with public libraries. And now we are upgrading all these computers we installed in 2008 to 2012. And it is led by Ministry of Transport and Communications. As you see, usually libraries are related with culture, with Ministry of Culture. But in our case, we are working very closely with Ministry of Interior, with Ministry of Transport and Communications. At the moment, planning the new period of European structure funds, we are working very closely with Ministry of Economics and Innovation. So it's not only about culture. We are working also with decreasing digital exclusion, social exclusion. We are working with lifelong learning. So it's not only about culture. Few words more about Project Libraries for Innovation. As I said, we got funding from Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation. It was a quite big amount of money and a very big impact to Lithuanian inhabitants. And we involved all public libraries. As you see in the picture, it looks quite crowded. But usually, as I said, 1,000 libraries are in rural areas. So that means that this library is only one librarian library, and usually it's the only place where inhabitants can get free services. They don't have to pay for it. And usually post offices, even schools, bank branches are closing in small areas, but libraries are still there and people need it. And even when libraries directors want to close few branch libraries, government does not always agree, because they're afraid to close it because of their community reaction, because people need libraries, and these unpopular decisions are not so good for politicians, but they are good for libraries, of course. Main results. When we started in 2007, we just measured the current situation, and we saw that only 60% of rural branch libraries had computers and internet. And when we finished, we had 93% of libraries who had internet and computers. And at the moment, we have 100% of libraries. When we started, only 30% of public librarians admitting having sufficient IT skills to provide access to the internet. So when we finished, after all these trainings to librarians, we saw a different situation. It was more than 83% librarians who were ready to train their users of IT skills. Another project also funded by Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation. It was a smaller project. It was about 4 million euros, but it was related only with soft activities. So for this amount of money, we could do a lot. And the goal was to help libraries feel more competitive in various European funding contests, national contests, not just to give them all infrastructure and activities, but we wanted to train them to create it by themselves. How to measure the needs of community, how to write the project, how to find partners, how to implement it successfully, how to make the project sustainable, and how to measure the impact. So we had more than 50 projects in small projects, small grant projects in this big project. And of course, we had more than 50 new services in different kind of regions. And it worked really very well. We even got news from Ministry of Culture that the applications of public libraries became better and better each year. And now I will speak about the results. We had a survey. We did it after 10 years. We ended the project in 2012, but our first measure of impact was done in 2009. And now in 2019, we were able to repeat this research. And the goal was to find out how users evaluate libraries, what is their opinion about public internet access, what they're doing using internet, what kind of habits they have. And it was an online research, and we had more than 4,500 respondents. And the results really are good. We are so happy that we got even 9.5 out of 10 from our users. They evaluated our services 9.5. It's a big number, and we are proud of it because some experts say that we should look at these numbers very carefully, not to be so happy, because usually our users are happy about the services, not because they are good, but they're telling that librarians are so good, they have small salaries, how can I give them less than 9 or 10? But we believe that this number is really, really, really shows the real situation, and that comparing with other culture institutions, we are doing it even better than them. Not to all culture institutions, they would give such big numbers, I wanted to say. So we found out that even 85% users visit libraries at least once a month. Usually it's one or two times per month. And we are so happy that rural libraries are visited at least once a week. Even 46% said that they're visiting libraries once a week. What kind of benefits we measured? Real impact to our users. So 6 out of 10 libraries users say that libraries help them to build skills and enrich personality. 5 out of 10 said that it helped them to solve practical problems. Without a library, they wouldn't be able to solve these problems. Maybe they're afraid to ask their children or grandchildren or friends, but they can always come to the library and ask librarians. So it helps them to solve practical problems. And even 4 out of 10 said that libraries help them to improve critical thinking. We added few questions related with media literacy, and we were so happy that it helps people to improve their critical thinking. 46% of our senior users said that libraries help them to find information about health. 39% said that libraries help to improve social life. 33% that it helped them to done the job better, and those who have low income, they said that it even helped them to earn some, to save some money, and even to find a job. Even 373 said that libraries helped them to find a job. So it's the real benefit, the real impact to our users. 15% of our users said that they don't have other opportunities to use internet elsewhere. But even 85% of our users have an opportunity to use a possibility to use internet elsewhere, but they're coming back to the libraries. So that number shows the real benefit of our services, and that they need it and they value it and they are glad to come back. Numbers show that the role of librarian has grown, and we started in 2009 with 22%, and now we have 46% of users that say that the role of the librarian has grown, and also the need of external devices has increased, and now we have even 54% of users who are telling that this is crucial to them. And the most important number is that even 62% at the moment of our users said that they have completely sufficient skills for using internet. When we started, they had 51%. 51% only said that they have sufficient skills, but that number is not so relevant in that year, because experts say that some users might not understand the real IT skills. I mean that they thought they have sufficient skills, but they didn't know what they can do else. So after trainings in 2010 or even 2011, we measured how our users rated their skills, and it was less, I think even 13%. But now in 2009, they said that even 62% said that they have sufficient skills. That's it. Thank you for your attention, and hope to see you alive someday.